The angel of the Lord encamp around those who fear him. Are not his ministers flames of fire? Angels. There is angelic assistance. Amen. Many people don't know, but there is angelic assistance for every believer.
Amen.
Angelic assistance. Jacob said, the angel that delivered me from evil. The angel that delivered me from evil. And then he tapped and said, rise up, eat. And then he ate. And he slept again. If you are in this honor and sleeping, I'm waking you up.
Amen.
To eat the word of God again.
Amen.
To eat the word of God. Out of the word, the strength will take you a long time.
Amen.
And the time they say, hey, Elijah, rise up and eat, for the journey is too long for thee.
Amen.
I pray the journey, though we are in September, to finish the year and to go into your destiny is too long.
Yes.
So this prophetic impartation, my father, rise up and eat the
rice.
And carry the word of God. And
Amen.
Let the word of God carry you to a long distance.
Amen.
So he rose up and with the strength of the food, he walked 40 days. 40 days is the day Jesus fasted 40 days. Moses fasted 40 days. And Elijah also spent 40 days because of the strength of the food. He had to walk to where Moses met God. This impartation, where our fathers met God, and they received impartation, and now it came to our generation. We must also receive it from them. That's the point. We must receive it so that we can also go and impact lives. I pray in the name of Jesus, where I felt to receive the power of the Holy Ghost, you will receive it now. And then it went to where Moses went to Mount Herod, and hid himself in one of the caves. And the Lord appeared to him and said, Elijah, what are you doing here? I have given you a mission. What are you doing here? Why have you resigned to apathy? What are you doing here? And then he began to complain and said, Israel has forsaken the Lord. They have torn all the orders of God down, forgotten the covenant and broken the covenant. And then they have killed all the prophets with sword. Only I. Don't think you are the only person in town. God is about to raise another generation.
Amen.
God is about to raise you.
Amen.
They say only I. And then God said, well, come, let me speak to you. So he came and stood in front of the cave. And then there was a strong wind. God has wept in the wind before. When Moses and the Israelites were coming, the blast of the noses of God, the wind, even blew the Red Sea into a sand, and then they had to pass through the dry land. So God wept with wind. One of the names of the Holy Spirit, the wind, is called Ruach. Ruach means wind. Breath. When they created man, there was no breath, and God breathed onto him, it was a wind. And became a living soul, Ruach. So God works with wind. So immediately saw the wind, and then the mountain began to shake. Say, this is God, this is God, this is God. But when the wind came and the mountain shaped, God was not in the wind. If you intellectualize, God will bypass you. The Bible says things that you don't respect, they are the things that God will use.
Amen.
And God will do a new thing.
Amen.
It will spring forth from the behind of this wind. And then God was not in the wind. And then there was an epic. was giving Moses the instruction to bring the children, the earthquake. And the people were begging Moses, please go and speak to God. We can't face him. Go and speak. So God had done it before. So immediately saw the mountain being broken into pieces. He said, this is God. God is coming. I'm waiting for him. But God was not the earthquake. And finally, God appeared to Moses in the fire. And there was a fire. And he just concluded, well, God will be in the fire. But God was not in the fire. God will surprise you.
Amen.
You see, there are sometimes things that you don't respect. Mm-hmm. What did I come? Things that you don't respect. That's why our meetings, I'm not going to intellectualize the meeting. Things that you don't respect. God can give impartation to you in the name of Jesus. It's not only during the prayer time, but God can do it now.
Amen.
Receive it now. God was not in these things. But later, something that God has never moved in, an honor that we have never had. Something that God has never done. God come, his voice is rocking and blowing, and people are afraid to hear. But God came with a surprise. May God surprise you.
Amen.
May Jehovah surprise you.
Amen.
Everybody here in this honor, may you receive an impartation of surprise.
Amen. I receive it in Jesus' name.
The words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. May you receive an impartation.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then God came in a still small voice. Something that God has never done. He is always doing a new thing. He said, behold, I'm doing a new thing. And unfortunately for the church, the traditional, the legalistic people, God says, I'm doing a new thing. And anytime God brings a new thing, they are the very people who oppose the new thing. And God said, I am doing a new thing.
We need a change.
You need a change.
Amen.
Don't be legalistic. This is how we've been doing, keeping the status quo. And the status quo is not working. And God is giving a new direction. He said, this is the way we should go. And they said, this is the way we have been doing it over the years. Peter, the professional fisherman, has been doing fishing all night long. He has been fishing all night long. And he didn't catch any fish. And when Jesus came there, Jesus didn't change the water. He didn't change the river. But the revelation, the direction, he can launch into the deep. The same water that you didn't catch in the deep. Now by the word of the Lord, you shall catch it. The same bed. Come, Baba.